Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. Welcome back to the videos on using the Connected Conform workflow with the Flame 2018.2 update. In part one of this series, you started off with one sequence in the Connected Conform. And as time went on, you were given another version of the edit to add to the job. This was easily accomplished by updating the sources sequence to accommodate any new media required for all the sequences, and the sources sequence even used markers to tell you what the update was. So part 2 picks up from where we left off, and you'll start adding VFX. Typically with this kind of job, you will get revised edits of the production at any point, but you'll deal with that when it happens. If you'd like to follow along, please go to part 1 to download the media and follow the steps to get to this point. So it's still Tuesday in your working week, and as you did in the previous video, you just added a 15-second version of the production to the project. So now you would like to start working on finishing and some initial VFX. You could go through the 15-second version and do some effects, then the 20-second version and redo the effects. This is not very productive, especially if the VFX work is the same across all the sequences. And what if you get another version of the edit? I doubt you'll be too pleased to redo the effects for a third time. So through the Connected Conform, Flame offers a much more elegant workflow. Close the sources sequence for the moment. With the open 15 and 20 second sequences, click the Create Sequence pull-down menu and choose Create Shots Sequence. This sequence assembles the longest instance of all the segments with any layering across all the connected sequences. So very importantly, the sources sequence deals with source media, and the shots sequence deals with segments in the edit. So the point of the shot sequence is that you do your VFX work on the longest segment of a shot, and all the VFX ripple and update all the other sequences linked via the Connected Conform. The little chain icon in each segment indicates that the segments are linked across the other connected sequences. Now with that explanation out of the way, switch over to the timeline view and swipe screen right to bring up the player. Still focusing on the shot sequence, let's apply a basic timeline effects. Go to the end shot. Now we'll do something blatantly obvious. Select the segment and call up the effects ribbon. You can use the button or press Ctrl Tab. Choose 2D Transform and scale the image back into the frame. This effect will be fine for our purposes. Now you can flick through the sequences tabs and manually locate the shot. Or a better way is to call up the contextual menu and find an option called Jump to Connected Segment. This dynamic submenu will update with all the options where this segment is linked. So flicking either to the 20 or 15 second versions of the edit, you will note that your VFX has not rippled through. This is because you need to go back to the shots sequence and call up the contextual menu again. Ensure you select Sync Connected Segments. Once again, navigating the different sequences of the Connected Conform, you will see that Timeline Effects has been applied to that segment. This is based on source frame accuracy. So if you had an animation on specific frames, the VFX should sync up to the media. Now let's copy this effect to all the other segments except for the layered stack. So in the shot sequence, hold Ctrl and multi-select the other segments. Drag the 2D transform from the effects bar and drop it onto the selection. Scrubbing the sequence, all the targeted segments have scaled back with the 2D transform. To sync the other sequences in the Connected Conform, Call up the contextual menu over the selection and choose Sync Connected Segments. In both the 15-second and 20-second versions of the edit, the Timeline Effects has updated all the selected segments. So this is working very well, but it is now Wednesday morning in your working week, and you've just been told that two extra versions of the edit are now available. So let's see how you would handle this situation using the Connected Conform. Switch back to the Conform view. Select your sources sequence in the Sequences reel and open it. So the current sources sequence and shots sequence are only connected to the 20-second and 15-second version of the edit. To bring in the other sequences, right-click on the events list and choose to load an AAF. Go to the AAF folder and go into the Wednesday directory. Here we have a 5-second and a 10-second version of the edit. Select both AAF files and import them into the Conform view. Flicking through both these sequences, they are unlinked and not currently part of the Connected Conform. This is not a necessary step, but I like to see it happen, so switch to the Sources Sequence tab. Click the Create Sequence pull-down menu and choose to update the Sources Sequence. Flame rescans all the sequences in the Sequences reel and re-imports any media needed to link all the conforms. Looking into the Sources Sequence, this time there are only two markers. This indicates that these two segments were extended with more media to accommodate the updates from the 10 and 5 second versions of the edit. So the media in all these sequences are now linked, but if you flick through the sequence tabs, there are no VFX on the new sequences. Switch to the shots sequence. As a reminder, the shots sequence is currently only linked to the 15-second and 20-second versions of the edit. To consider the 10 and 5-second version of the edit, click the Create Sequence pull-down menu and choose Update Shots Sequence. A pop-up menu appears asking what should be reviewed in order to sync the VFX in the sequences. The default settings are typically the norm, and you can clear up any markers from previous updates with the shot sequence. Click Update. There is a slight update in the shot sequence, but if you switch to the 10-second or 5-second version of the edit, you will see that the segments have been linked and all the VFX have synced up. Even calling up the contextual menu and choosing Jump to Connected Segment will reveal the link between the segment across the multiple sequences. So if you were to adjust or add any VFX in the shots sequence or any of the other linked sequences, you would sync the VFX and this would now ripple across all the connected versions. So Wednesday has been a great day and you've managed to get your timeline effects completed as well as added a couple more versions of the edit to the Connected Conform. Everything is synced up, and you're ready for the next challenge of performing some batch node compositing in the upcoming days. We'll tackle that in the next part of this series, and I'm sure there might be one more version of the edit to add to the Connected Conform. Don't forget to also check out the other enhancements, workflows, and features to the Flame 2018.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.